it is time for my top 5 theme parks that I've been to. So at number 5 spot, we have Liseberg. So this is a good amusement park, but the special thing about this is that this is located on a hill where, yeah, normally would amusement parks, they are located in a city or something like that. This is located on a hill, also in a city, but on a hill. That makes in for some insane view. That is the main reason why I like this park so much. Yeah, I would say that the top 5 is way better than the rest, but if it wasn't for the location of this park, this would probably be, yeah, equal to the ones behind it. But yeah, this is definitely for the whole family. There is a lot of attractions for everyone. The top 3 rides for me in this park is 1, Helix, for sure, with a long shot. And here comes the controversial thing. For me, number 2 is Lisebergbanen. It's such a fantastic coaster, it hugs the terrain for the entire time. It's a long ride and it's quite intense, and I have some really, really good airtime and some really good laterals. So I think this is better than Battler and Valkyria. And then I also think Hotelgästen, the haunted house, the scare maze there, that is also a cracking, amazing ride. I mean, it's, yeah, it's so scary, it's so terrifying, it's so well themed. So yeah, just a better experience than the other coasters, in my opinion. So now for some park ratings. The atmosphere at this park, I have to give it a perfect 10 out of 10. Especially, yeah, when the night comes, it's absolutely incredible. And for theming and beauty, yeah, they make really, really well themed ride for being an amusement park and not a theme park. And then the park is incredibly beautiful, and the location makes it even more beautiful. And the rides and attractions here is getting a 10 as well. Yeah, 10 for every category. Have 2 excellent water rides, several amazing coasters, probably the best top 4 of coasters in any parks in Europe, in my opinion. And yeah, this park just pretty much have everything in terms of rides. Yeah, it could probably use another a good dark ride or something like that, but yeah, top-notch flat ride collection, top-notch coaster collection, and good water rides. I have to give it a 10. And my overall score is also going to be a 10. Number 4, I have Fantasialand. So about the same size as Liseberg, a pretty small park, at least small compared to my top 3 parks. That is probably therefore that these two are, yeah, ended up in the bottom of the top 5, because I think they are about the same quality as the top 3. Yeah, maybe even higher than at least the bottom of the top 3, the number 3 spot. But the difference from Liseberg is that this is definitely a theme park. And it is also for the entire family, I would say, some excellent family rides, some excellent food rides. We have everything. Yeah, this is just one of these parks where a themed area will feel like you are in that area. I mean, for example, deep in Africa, you will feel like you're in Africa. And the new area, Hoopbrook, you will feel like that you are in, yeah, some steampunk kind of theme in Berlin. Yeah, 100 years ago, it's just amazing. Also, Klugheim just amazed you so well into that, yeah, kind of mystical world. It's amazing. I love Fantasialand's areas. My top 3 rides from here is number 1, Taron, with a long shot. I still think it's, yeah, definitely the best. Now said long shot, yeah, that's just because I know it's my number 1 for sure, but I also know that I also love Chiapas and Fly, which is my number 2 and number 3. I think Chiapas is the perfect non-coaster ride. It has a good flow, it's a fantastic log flume, some really good special effects, some excellent theming, and it is probably the most well-presented ride that I've ever been on. It is insane. And number 3 for me is Fly. It actually exceeded my expectations, because I didn't expect to like it that much, because I'm not a fan of flying coaster. But the whole experience of this one was absolutely excellent. One of the best ones, yeah, that I've ever experienced. Yeah, Wood Fantasia and these three rides are all among my favorite rides that I've ever been on. Now for some park ratings. The atmosphere here is going to get a 9 out of 10. It would definitely have been getting a 10 if it wasn't for the area when you go left. You know, with Winchester, fantasy area there. It's still good, that indoor area and the outdoor area around it, but yeah, mostly with the ride Crazy Bats with the Coma indoor coaster. That area there, that isn't perfect, so therefore I can't give it a 10 out of 10. And now for some theming and beauty, it's getting a 10. It is perfect, in my opinion. And rides and attractions here, they are also getting a 10. They have something for everyone. Great water rides, great dark rides, amazing coasters, both family and full, and some good bad rides as well. Perfect ride lineup, in my opinion. And that leads into a personal overall rating of 10 out of 10. At number 3, we have Port Aventura. So, this park is huge. It is amazing. It is beautiful. The main reason why it makes it over some of those parks, Fantasialand and Liseberg, is because of the size. Because I think they definitely do something better than Port Aventura. This is a theme park, and it's for all ages, I would say, again. For the entire family can enjoy this park. The top three rides here for me is number 1, Shambhala, for sure. Number 2, you might not even have heard about this, but the Port Aventura Parade plus nighttime show over the lake is by far the best show that I've ever seen. It is absolutely incredible. I really enjoy this show. It is some mind-blowing light effect show. It is just that good. And number 3 for me is Furious Backhoe. I love this coaster and I think it's incredibly underrated. But I can also understand why some people don't like it, but I absolutely love it. It's just the ride for me. It is so intense, so low to the ground, and incredibly well paced and doesn't let you breathe at all. It's just insane, this ride. The park is big. It's split up to different kind of areas, the themed areas, and they are all really, really well themed and really atmospheric. And it is getting a 10 out of 10 in atmosphere. Theming and beauty here. Beauty will get a absolute 10, but some rides are not that well themed. Many rides are not that well themed. I would say Fierce Backhoe is one of the coasters that is like really well themed. Dragon Khan and Shambhala doesn't have that much theming. The area are well themed, but the coasters is not that well themed, to be honest. So therefore I can only give it a 9 with the theming and beauty. Now for some rides and attractions here, and this is getting a 10, no doubt. The rides and attractions there are excellent. Many full coasters. A lot of shows as well. Many water rides. We have 4 different water rides. That is crazy. And they might lag a bit of flat rides, but they make up for the quantity of all the other rides. It is incredible. And it's of course getting an overall score of 10 out of 10. So, at number 2 spot, I have Europa Park. So, this is definitely a theme park, and this is huge. This is for everyone. This is one out of 2 parks that I say is for everyone. That is because this both have some good thrill rides, some good family rides, some good kiddie rides. And for old people who, not necessarily want to go on any rides at all, this park is just incredibly pleasant to be in. And they have a lot of good restaurants, so they can come and have a good time anyways. And this is just amazing. So now, my top 3 rides at Europark. So, number 1 for me is Wodan, the GCI wooden coaster. Might not be the best wooden coaster out there, but it is still a great wooden coaster. It is... I love all GCIs, and this is no exception. Then it's also really, really well themed, so that's just a good bonus. Number 2 is Silver Star for me, a great B&M hypercoaster with a lot of good floater airtime. The second half is actually better than the first. This might be a really non-Europark ride, but it is still one of the best rides in the park. Yeah, what I mean about that is how it's located in the car park, where all the other rides here is immersive with theming all surrounding the ride. Silver Star is an exception there, but it's still a great ride. And number 3 is Blue Fire. This might change a bit because I heard many people say it's completely forceless and have really bad pacing. And if it is just like Star Trek, but even without VR time, then this will move down a lot and I will probably prefer some other rides here like Euromir, Eurosat Cancan Coaster, R2 of the new ride there, or new since I was there, it's not new anymore. But yeah, anyways, now for some park ratings. The atmosphere here is getting a 10 out of 10, no doubt. It is one of the best atmospheres for any parks that I've visited. It could even, yeah, break the scale, but 10 out of 10 for atmosphere, perfect. Now for some theming and beauty, it is also getting a 10. This park is absolutely beautiful, and yeah, most of the rides are incredibly well themed. It is just perfect. The ride lineup might not be perfect, but it's still getting a 10 out of 10 because it is close to perfect. What I'm missing here is that one coaster that just wows the shit out of you. They don't have that. They have Rodan, the best ride there in my opinion, but none of the coasters or rides are absolutely world class or anything. They're just all great, and they have so much of it that I still have to give it a 10. And my overall score is of course going to be a 10 out of 10. So my favorite park that I've ever been to is Efteling. This might be a controversial choice, but for me Efteling is everything that I like combined into a park. It is absolutely incredible. You have that massive first impressions by this huge entrance. I'm pretty confident that this is the most beautiful entrance to any theme parks in the world. It is huge. I think it's about 50 or 60 meters tall. It is absolutely crazy to, yeah, just stand there, and already there you will know that this is a special park, and it certainly is. Going in, yeah, you just have that magical feeling just from your inside the park, and that feeling will not leave you until you walk outside of the park again. It is just amazing. Such a good theme park. And yeah, it is definitely for families and all ages, I would say. The reason that I don't say everyone here is because this is more to the childish side. It is not a children park at all. But fairy tales would probably not be anything for old people who come here, or some adults also might only be theme park enthusiasts. But if this park just is a hit for someone, then it would be a massive hit. And it is that for me, as you can see. It is my favorite park. And now for some of my favorite rides here. Number 1, I recently changed my opinion here. So now my favorite ride at this park is Fliegenhollander. It is absolutely incredible. It's just, yeah, it's such a unique ride, and it's half dark ride, half coaster. The dark ride part is by far my favorite part of this ride. But my favorite thing about this ride is the whole experience, how the queue line just builds up, and then the station is incredible. It is huge and it looks like a haven. It's just beautiful. Then the dark ride kicks in and it starts with complete darkness and then some incredible special effects. And then a little coaster part. And the coaster part might not be anything special at all, but it's more than enough with the entire experience here. It is amazing. Such a dark themed ride, and I just love this one. Number 2 is Symbolica. Completely the opposite. Such a feel heavy ride, this one. Yeah, just theme to that palace and you're visiting it, and might not have a complete great storyline or anything, but it is beautiful and it is so well themed. It's such an advanced system that this dark ride uses, this trackless system. And yeah, just one incredible ride. And my number 3 ride here is Jolies in the Drag, the GCI Dueling wooden coaster. So yeah, Jolies in the Drag, such a good coaster. One of my favorite GCIs, and yeah, here's an interesting thing about Efteling. Me and my good friend Christopher visited this park, and we spent 13 and a half hours at this park. And we didn't even rode Baron Axen Axen Eggenen, once. Yeah, the queues was about 1.5 hours, but it's still insane how you can come to a park and don't even miss anything without even riding the tallest and fastest coaster at the park. Because we didn't miss it at all, and when we was leaving the park, we was like, we didn't get on that, but that's fine, because we got on all the other things, and yeah, we didn't even have that craving of getting that ride, and we have done it before, but yeah. When a park can make you forget about hill coasters that are located in the park, then that's a good sign of this park. It's absolutely incredible. Now for some park ratings. The atmosphere, that just cracks the scale for me. The atmosphere here are like no other parks that I've been to. Like I said in the beginning, this park just had that magical feeling stomp into you from the moment you walk in the entrance to the moment you walk out again. Where other parks, you kind of forgot about the magics, maybe when you're waiting in the lines, but not for Efteling, in my opinion. And theming and beauty here, this place is beautiful and all the rides are incredibly well themed. Absolute 10 out of 10, no doubt. Rides and attractions here are also getting a 10 out of 10. Again, just like Euro Park, they could have that one wow ride that just, yeah, is much better than all the other ones. But I think this one have two where, yeah, they are really, really close to be absolutely world-class rides. And then they also have some really unique rides, like for example, we have a big fairy tale forest. I consider that an attraction as well. It takes about an hour to walk through and it's just beautiful and amazing and so unique. Good water ride, Piranha. World-class dark rides. Yeah, that is the best quality of rides here. The dark rides here are absolutely incredible. So overall, my personal score for Efteling is going to be a 10 out of 10, of course. So that has been everything from this video and all the videos. So thanks guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video.